Managing reference data poorly can have a profound impact on your operations as well as business intelligence and analytical outcomes. Here are my 5 best practices for managing reference data. If you're new to this channel or you haven't subscribed yet, please click on the subscribe and bell buttons as it's free and it really helped me out a lot. Thank you. Now, on to the 5 best practices for managing reference data. First is to formalize reference data management, or RDM. Most often than not, reference data is not maintained if there is no accountability and ownership determined. Usually, the IT team performs the initial load into the applications or central repository. In cases such as a one-time data quality effort, adoption of a new application, or a data integration project. But then they do not worry about keeping it up to date. Business users lack the time, resources, and even understanding of tracking the changes required and keeping it up to date. At best, this is done at the system level or report level and not enterprise-wide. This can be addressed in multiple ways. The best case scenario is to create an enterprise reference data unit, also called the reference data working group, reference data owners, reference data stewards, reference data committee council, etc. Many names for it. This central group oversees reference data management across the enterprise, and it is supporting the business needs accordingly. Another way is to ensure that reference data management is in scope of data governance, or that the RDM responsibilities are included in the data stewardship job descriptions. If this is not part of your data governance scope already, make sure its management is approved as a program and not just a one-time project. Second, subscribe to external reference data. As a default, it's recommended to first consult reference data provided by third-party standard authorities such as ISO, SWIFT, ACORD, ICD, and so on. Defaulting to these saves a lot of time internally, excluding the resources required to discover, understand, adopt, and sometimes purchase this data, of course. But you can be confident you're adopting the standards from a reliable source. Adopting this data does not ensure a subscription to any updates, so you need to ensure any changes done by the third-party authority are quickly determined and integrated into your master tables. For example, country codes change on an average of 3 times per year, apparently. Sometimes a paid subscription is available, which would allow instant notification or integration with your technical environment via an API. Please keep in mind that the ramifications for updating this data don't just stop at the table level, but they carry on within documentation and training, metadata and definitions, as well as anything that's hard-coded, such as forms, reports, and dashboards. Please check out this video on the 3 crucial tips of using ISO 3166 reference data in order to, well, to see how you can use the ISO 3166 reference data and optimize your list of countries in your databases, in your tables. Third is to govern internal reference data. Internal reference data are completely specific to your enterprise. In contrast to the external reference data, the team responsible for the internal reference data needs to focus on the development of good reference data. Managing this data needs a defined process, guidelines, and ownership. Reference data management needs to be formalized, right? See that first best practice that we talked about. And the assigned individuals responsible for this last piece need to work with the data governance team in ensuring the development of standards and guidelines, ownership, identification, and following the operation model. And they also need to work with the technical team, which is usually IT, in order to be aware of any technical considerations and ensure the IT delivery aligns with the reference data standards. Also, the executives for acquiring support and resources, and business stakeholders to acquire definitions, use cases, information and feedback, as well as to ensure that adoption. Before we cover the last 2 best practices, I would like to say thank you to the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, a business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. You can use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Fourth is to manage reference data at an enterprise level. Reference data management needs to support multiple domains in order to avoid reference data silos. This outcome is dependent on the data governance operating model that you are adopting. As this becomes widely used across different enterprise systems, distribution of updates and new entries need to be addressed. A data bus or a data hub is a common solution as it provides a central location from which any application can import its reference data from. This import can happen automatically by pulling the data through an API, a subscription type, or an automatic read-write function, or manually by a batch or a static file. If the import occurs manually due to technical limitations, communications of any updates occurring at the data bus level should be passed on to the data stewards within the impacted business domains and the data custodians of the impacted applications and systems. Lastly, version your reference data. As reference data has a wide prevalence across your systems, you not only need to ensure it is up to date across the enterprise, but that you can keep track of its changes. This is particularly useful in data integration projects, addressing master data management needs, and business intelligence deliverables. One needs to know the effective date of the change and what was it changed from in order to address all of these. Have you considered managing your reference data? What best practices did you adopt or create? Please like the video if you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to click on the subscribe button to be notified when a new video comes out. Thank you.